So today again is March 20th, 2020, and I'm here and you can see the big Indian down here at Riverside Park in La Crosse, Wisconsin. This is where I was born. I was born in 1958, September 12th, and this is my hometown. But of course, my home state now is Alaska. And if some of you want to watch videos about my support of Donald Trump in Alaska, you can watch those. I'll have those also posted on YouTube. But I want to take a few minutes to explain a little about what's actually happened for myself as a missionary in China. Real quickly, and this is just a brief description and explanation of 35 years in China, okay? So I went to China in August of 1985. I started school. It's kind of interesting that my first day in language studies, learning the Chinese language, was on September 12th, 1985. That would have been my 27th birthday. And I have been in China for 35 years. So I studied the language for 6 years, 4 years in university, 2 years I hired a private tutor to work with me with the language. I speak fluent Mandarin. I actually have YouTube videos right now that are being posted every day, 3 to 5 minute Mandarin Chinese Bible studies, and I post those on YouTube. But like I say, I'm going to also post the videos of me in Alaska supporting Donald Trump, also talking about China and the ministry. But getting back to my 35 years, so language school for 6 years, then for the next 15, 20 years, underground church work, planting churches, working with churches outside of Beijing up in the northeast of China. I actually was instrumental in rescuing 14 North Koreans from North Korea into China, out of China into Seoul, South Korea. That's a whole nother story. Absolutely amazing what God did in that situation. And some of those people I led to Christ. They were not all Christians, the North Koreans. But today I believe all of them are, and they're safe in South Korea. But setting that aside, that brings us to, in the 1980s, I lived through the 89 massacre. And of course, during that whole situation, I was instrumental in helping to protect Chinese people. I was not involved with the student movement. I do not make political statements protesting in Beijing. I stayed away from them. But I did work to make sure that Christian friends, other friends, even foreign friends, were safe during those violent years in 1989, those 50 days. Someone had turned me in, actually as a believer, and I'll put that in quotations, a Christian, had given information to the police. I was arrested. I was held for 15 days in interrogation, but by the grace of God, I knew a police officer that was a good friend of mine. All charges were lifted. He released me. Minimal fine. Nothing on my record. That was 1991. And then, and what's interesting about that, sometimes it's amazing how God works, is that I was released on my birthday, September 12th, in 1991. So held for 15 days, but released on my birthday. So for whatever that's worth, my birthday all the time. But so then that brings me into the 90s. I worked to be a tennis instructor for Communist Party leaders. Can you imagine this? For 9 years, from 1993, 8.5 years, from 1993 all the way to 2001. 3 times a week, I met with government leaders in Beijing and taught them to play tennis. Backhands, forehands, overheads. And I got an incredible education of who the Communist Party was by spending time with these guys. So I'm here to tell you that I absolutely hate the Communist Party. That does not mean I hate those Communist Party leaders. Now, I do hate their ideology, and it would appear to them at times that I hate them, but they knew for 8.5 years that I was a good teacher of tennis. So setting all that aside, it was an education in learning what's going on in China. So that brings us up into the 90s. And then, of course, when you get into the 2000s, that was when I started a rescue ministry for abandoned babies. In 2004, I rescued my first child. And over the years, over 10 years, I rescued 16 babies. 5 of them died from terminal illness. 1 of them was killed by the Communist Party. And 10 of them were raised in a Christian homeschooling under the radar. And it wasn't until 2014 that someone, once again, a so-called Christian, gave information and the police found out about me with the 10 children. The media went crazy. That would have been November of 2014. They attacked me. I fought with the media. Can you imagine this? One guy, and this is the grace of God, this is where Donald Trump understands this, Mike Pence for sure, and Mike Pompeo, you guys understand that apart from the grace of God, I mean, how do we survive today? But in 2014, systematically from November to December of 2014, I fought with the media of China, newspapers, television, radio, and by the grace of God and by the power of prayer, is that by myself, no lawyers helped me, no government assistance, didn't go to the government to seek assistance, is I was able to clear myself of all the charges and even spent the next 6 months fighting with the newspaper that originally published the false accusations against me. I overturned the story and republished an article in their newspaper in Chinese. Now, of course, all that caused the Communist Party leadership, and that would be Xi Jinping on down, they were furious about this situation. So that was 2014. What happened to my 10 kids? They were taken in custody. What happened to Phoebe, an 8-year-old girl? She was in need of an operation. They neglected her in the hospital and systematically starved her to death while she sat alone, laid alone in intensive care. But God knows all these things. He will bring justice. My prayer is that they would repent, turn from their sinfulness, turn to Jesus Christ. And that's been my focus over the last 35 years. And that's what I really want to share about myself, is that although it sounds like I'm a political activist now, because I don't see myself going back to China, one, it'd be too dangerous now, but, you know, but the Lord has protected me over 35 years. There were many, 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 many dangerous situations, but through it all, God protected. Now, I know that if I were to return to Beijing, that would be the end of me. So I'm here in America, and the only time I'm going back to China, and this is my plea to you in America and for the world as well, is that we're finished. We are finished with the Communist Party of China. We will not work with Communist Red China. We will work with the Chinese people. We will work with anyone that stands up for freedom and stands up for the love of God and stands up for the love of man, but we will not work communism anymore. That's my plea. That's my passion. And yes, I love children. You can check my website out, www.mefoundation.world. But from a political standpoint, I have no choice but to be a political activist right now. And that's because I don't want communism anywhere in the world, and especially in America. So don't even think about voting for somebody that's a socialist communist. But by the grace of God, yes, this is not a political advertisement, but I'll throw it out there anyway. Vote for Donald Trump in November of 2020. Thank you, Jesus, for answered prayer.